Assalamu alaikum boys and girls, today we are going to continue our topic, the trigonometric ratios and trigonometric formulas. Our next lesson is about compound angle formulas. The formulas, how to derive these formulas is not, you have no concern with it. The formulas is written, formulas are written on the board in front of you. In compound angle formula, the first formula is sine A plus B. The sine of two angles A plus B will be sine of A cos of B plus cos of A into sine of B. So we have two angles A and B. If you apply sine on it, so it will be written as sine A into cos B plus cos A into sine B. Sine of A minus B, difference of two angles, will be sine of A cos B, same as the terms in the previous formula. Only difference is the sine between these two terms. So we have sine A cos B minus cos A sine B. So the difference in these two is a sine of minus sine. So when we have addition of two angles, there will be plus sign between the two terms in the expansion. And in case of minus, we have minus. Cosine of A plus B will be cos A into cos B minus sine A into sine B. Cosine of A minus B will be cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. Again, the difference is the minus sign. For the plus addition of two angles, we have minus sign between the two terms. And in case of difference of two angles, we have plus sign between the two terms. Cos A, cos B, sine A, sine B. Tan A plus B will be tan A plus tan B over 1 minus tan A tan B. For plus sign, we have a plus sign here and minus sign in the denominator. Tan A minus B will be tan A minus tan B. For minus sign, we have minus between tan A and tan B. And in the denominator, we'll have plus sign. So we'll make use of these formulas today. Master. I have written the same formulas again for your convenience. While applying the formula, we can refer to the formulas written on the right top corner. The question, first question that we are going to solve by applying this formula is find the value of sine 105 degree. To find the value of sine 105, using the compound angle formula, I can write it as I have splitted 105 into two angles whose values are known to me. Now I can apply the formula. The first one, it can be written as sine 60 cos 45 plus cos 60 sine 45 as sine A cos B, then cos A sine B. If there is a plus sign between, we have to use the plus sign. The value you can find from the calculator, sine 60 is equal to root 3 over 2. Cos 45 is 1 over root 2. Plus cos 60 is 1 over 2. Into sine 45 is 1 over root 2. Take LCM, 2 root 2, we left with root 3 plus 1. So this is our final answer. So what I have done to find the value of sine 105, I have written 105 as 60 plus 45. So here I have to use two angles whose values are known to me. I want to find the exact value of For exact value, we cannot use decimal fractions. We are using thirds and proper fractions for exact values. Here we need exact value. So when the question, demand of the question is to find the exact value, we are bound to use the thirds and the proper fractions. We cannot use the decimal fractions that values we get from the calculator. That's why we are bound to use the compound angle formula. So look at this expansion. It is similar to cos A, cos B, sine A, sine B with plus sign. So if there is a plus sign, it means I can write it as I am using actually cos A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. So similar to these two terms we have here, there is a plus sign, we have a plus sign. So it means we can write this expression in this form. So cos 42 I can write it as cos 42 minus 12, that will be cos 30, and its value is known to me, root 3 over 2. This is how we apply these compound formulas. So what I have done here, I have compared this expression with this formula. We have cos 42, cos 12, sine 42, sine 12. So it is similar to this expansion. There is a plus sign, so I know when we put the plus sign, when there is a minus in the difference of angles. So I have used this formula. This expansion is changed into cos 42 minus 12. That gives me cos 30, and value of cos 30 is root 3 over 2. Another type of question which will be asked in this exercise are given is sine of angle A is 4 over 5 and cos of angle B is 5 by 13. A is obtuse and B is acute. We have to find the values of sine A plus B, cos A minus B, tan A minus B. Now the given is A is obtuse angle, B is acute angle, and the values of sine A is given and cos B is given. So using this information, first of all, I have to find the values of other trigonometric ratios like cos A and tan A, sin B and tan B using this information. For angle A, it is obtuse. It means A is in second quadrant. So make a right angle triangle here. So A is obtuse angle. So right angle triangle I have formed here. Value of sine A is 4 by 5. I know sine A is 4 by 5. Sine is perpendicular over hypotenuse. It means its perpendicular is 4 units. Hypotenuse is 5 units. Making use of Pythagoras, we can find its base. So base square is equal to hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square. That will give me 5 square minus 4 square is equal to 25 minus 16, 9. So base is 3. So this base is 3. But it is on the negative sides of x-axis. So I consider it as negative 3. So what I have done using the information of sine A is equal to 4 by 5 and secondly A is obtuse. So if it is A is obtuse, then this angle lies in second quadrant. So I have drawn a line which represents the angle A and I have made a right angle triangle by dropping a perpendicular on x-axis. As I know sine A is 4 by 5 and sine is equal to perpendicular over hypotenuse. For this base angle, I'm not using angle A, I'm using the base angle which is from the nearest x-axis. For the base angle, perpendicular is 4 units, hypotenuse is 5 units, that is given here in sine. So making use of hypotenuse and perpendicular, I have calculated the base. That is 3 units, but because it is on the left side, it is on negative side of x-axis, so I can taking it as negative 3. Now using this information, I can find cos A. I know cos is base over hypotenuse. And I can find tan A. Tan is perpendicular over base. So perpendicular is 4, base is negative 3. We know in second quadrant, for obtuse angle, cos is negative. That's why we are getting negative 3 over 5. And tan is also negative in second quadrant. That's why we are getting tan is equal to minus 4 over 3. If I am not using this negative sign over here, even then I can decide because it is second quadrant, A is obtuse angle, so the cosine will be negative 3 by 5 and tan is also negative. But if I put a negative sign here, it's better to give a negative sign to 3. In that way, it's better to avoid a mistake. Now, for angle B, B is acute. Acute means it is in first quadrant. B is in first quadrant. So again, make a right angle triangle. It is cos B is 5 by 13. So cos is base over hypotenuse. So its base is 13 unit. Base is 5 units and hypotenuse is 13 unit. Making use of Pythagoras theorem, I can find the perpendicular. That gives me 13 square minus 5 square, 169 minus 25, 144. So P will be 12. So its perpendicular is 12. So using this information, using this diagram, I can find sine B. Sine B is perpendicular over hypotenuse. That is 12 over 13 and tan B. Tan is perpendicular over base, that is 12 over 5. And because B is in first quadrant, so sine and tan both are positive as well. Because B is in, it is acute angle, it is in first quadrant, so sine, tan, cos all are positive. So these values are known to me now. So using these values, now I can find any compound angle. Like he said, find sine A minus B. I know it is equal to sine A cos B minus cos A sine B. So I can use the values that I have calculated. Sine A is 4 by 5. Cos B, 5 by 13. Cos A, minus 3 by 5. And sine B is 12 by 13. So 5 into 13, 65 is your LCM. 20 plus these two signs becomes plus 36. That will be 56 by 65. So this is how we are going to use this formula, and all the information I have, the given information was sine, about sine A and cos B, and about angle A and B. Using this information, I have calculated sine B, tan B, cos A, tan A, and then using these values, I can calculate any angle given. My question says, find cos A plus B. I know it is equal to so using the values, I can calculate cos A plus B. So cos A is minus 3 by 5. Cos B is 5 by 13 minus sine A is 4 by 5 and sine B is 12 by 13. 65 is the LCM. We get minus 15 and minus 48. Minus 63 by 65. Uh बस ठीक करेक्ट। Another example, solve the equation sine 60 minus 6 is equal to 2 sine x and x is between 0 to 60. Range of the angle is given, all four quadrants are available, and we have to find the value of x. On the left side, we have sine 60 minus x, and I am going to expand it using the formula. Sine 60 is root 3 over 2. Cos 60 is 1 over 2. Taking LCM. Cross multiplying. I'm shifting this sign to the other side. Root 3 cos x is equal to 5 sine x, and I want to solve. And you know, when you want to solve an equation, trigonometric equation, we need to have only one trigonometric ratio, either sine or cos or tan. So I can change it into tan if I want. If I divide both sides by cos, I left with root 3 over 5 is equal to 10x. Ten x is equal to root 3 over 5. So using the calculator, we can find the value of x. That would be 19.1. One degree, that is in the first quadrant, and we know tan is positive in the third quadrant as well, and for that purpose it will be somewhere here. Let me draw it again for you. We have angle here, that is 19.1, and another angle here, 19.1. So other angle is 180 plus 19.1 and 199.1. Two angles are so it is quite easy to use these formulas, nothing special in it. So I'm going to send you a worksheet, try it at home, and we'll see the later if there is any problem. Thank you. That's all for today.